How are y'all doing this evening? It is Thursday evening. I'm normally playing, but we're not playing due to a couple of reasons. COVID, and actually, honestly, the owner of the place where we play is sick with other things, not COVID related, but he's not doing well. So his name is Adrian. If you could lift him in prayer. I'm way out here in Avondale right now getting ready to meet Gloria. We're going to hang out for a little bit. I'm trying to meet her at her friend Cindy's house out here in Avondale. There's a bad accident, so I can't turn. And I'm lost, so she has to come and rescue me. I'm over here at this food city outside waiting for her. So stay tuned. We'll get together. I just went to Olive Garden with some friends of mine. They were so cool, man. They treated me to dinner, and they bought me a really awesome tasting bottle of Roscato, which is like a wine, like a red wine. Oh my god, it was so good. It was like the best thing I've ever had. I'm gonna share that with Gloria right now if she wants to, and that ought to be interesting. See you guys in a few. Here we are, my leftover Olive Garden. I already did a video in the car.
Oh yeah,
telling them what we're gonna do. We're gonna get together.
Sorry, hold on.
I said, you know, because I go, I have this leftover bottle of wine. I'm gonna see if Toti wants to share with me. That ought to be interesting. Yeah. Roscato from exclusively from Olive Garden. My salad and shrimp, scampi. Oh my goodness, it was so bomb. Okay, we'll be back in a minute. Back, guys.
What?
We're having a little.
We're being wine-us. Cheers.
Cheers.
Here's to
the new year.
Goodbye, toxic relationships and coronas.
And hello, New Year.
And hello, New Year's. Wait, what else?
Merry Christmas.
Fuck those assholes. Ooh, I love this stuff.
This is Roscato exclusively from Olive Garden.
Man, who's Roscato? Who's your who? Who's Roscato what?
This is the best wine I've ever had. And I'm not a wine-a, but.
Yeah, right.
I'm not. I don't. This is the first time I had wine in years. Green Giant. That's what made me think.
Remember Green Giant?
Yeah.
You know that every time, like, you remember when you drive to California and you're, like, actually passing the border, like, where you think check you, and it's where it's, Blythe?
Probably,
it's all,
yeah.
Like, farming. Uh-huh. And it smells like green because of the...
Farm and stuff.
The farms and stuff. But you know what I think about all the time? When I smell that green stuff? Not the green stuff, but the green... The green, you know, the wet,
yeah.
Dirt and the green.
Yeah.
I think of the Green Giant.
Really?
I always do. That was the weirdest thing ever. I think that if the Green Giant were to sweat and his sovacos would smell like that.
That's why he's the mascot for vegetables.
Well, I guess. I don't know. That's what I think it smells like. It's like, smell that. It's the Jolly Green Giant and his nice mustache. I'm just off the charts here, guys.
I wish we would have been recording earlier because, man, we were hysterical, man. We and how do we don't catch this some of this stuff, man?
I don't know, but I think I'm over here all.
So yeah. I took a drive across town in the rain to see my
shorties. I saw you, but driving in the rain.
Anyways, how's everybody out there tonight?
Hola.
We're not trying to get buzzed. We're just relaxing so we can have a ladies' night of chat.
Yeah.
A table talk. And all that stuff, you know?
All that jazz.
Yeah.
All that freaking jazz.
I had to come and see how she's holding up.
Man, you know, I gotta tell you that, first of all, when my cousin does all that editing and stuff for our Divas,
Yeah.
It's like, I've been right now going through so much things.
I know.
That when your chica over here goes through some things, the other half of those divas,
yeah.
I tend to climb myself up. I would like become a hermit.
Right. She was doing that.
I totally disconnect myself from everything.
And I was feeling like...
Lost? No. I was feeling lost.
I was. It's like a twin thing, you know, when I could feel that you're like going through that.
Yeah.
Even though I'm way over there, so I came way over here just to make sure.
Yeah, she lives over there in where?
Pinnacle Peak.
Pinnacle Peak and Chingaderas.
I live in Cape. No, I live the freeway and Deer Valley or something.
Yeah, somewhere out there. But anyhow, it's crazy because I'm living in Avondale now.
Yeah.
You know what, cuz? You know what? You know what song I think about right now?
Mm.
Let me play it and I'll show you. And ladies and gentlemen, everything you hear on our YouTube, Facebook, all
unless I wrote it, we don't own the rights to it.
We don't own the rights to it. Let's just put it out there just for the simple fact that it is what it is. But you know what my life feels like right now?
Huh?
Name that tune. You can't say
name that tune.
Okay. I'll show you right now. Hey. There's gonna be a commercial, so ignore that.
Wow, I always have to have commercials all the time.
I know. Hey, the next time I'm gonna go over to Mandy's, we can yell all we want over there.
Yeah. Oh my god, right now Christian's playing his video games over there, and my head hurts from hearing him scream.
Huh.
I need to get out of there for a while, man. Gosh.
Who is it? Oh, yeah, this is official. This is what my life feels like right now.
You know what this song is? If you only knew what this song means to me. My grandma was so proud because I used to sing it when I was real small. And we were in Indiana and to Kentucky and all these places visiting. And I would have my little record with me. She would make me sing that everywhere we went. This song.
Did you have like a little record thing?
I used to carry a little record player.
That's what I remember then.
Yeah, a little like blue case that you could open and plug it in and it would play records.
Yeah.
That's what a nerd I was about. I was like so into music as a kid. So they never had to worry about me as long as I had that little record player.
So that's
so when I sing it and it goes, still see all your fire. I always think of her because I still like, it's like, it just represents her to me. I don't know why that song. Yeah. And it also represents to me like, even though she's weird and a witch and she talks about being a gypsy or whatever,
yeah.
I feel like it means, like, to me, it's everything we're about because it's about being, like, strong and being strong and, like, what's the word? Content alone.
Yeah. You know
and
what?
And your womanhood, like.
And I gotta say this. Let me pause you,
Stevie.
Stevie needs. I had to say that it's like all my life, I mean, the way my life has been.
Yeah, it's and like, it's like we're always moving.
We're always moving. I always moved as a kid.
Me too,
because we're like gypsies, man.
It's and always been like that. And I always want so bad my own home, my own stability. That's what you want too.
Yeah.
And we never get that.
You never get that. I don't know.
And I don't know if it's good or bad because what if we get it and then what?
There were like...
Now what?
Sorry, Jack, but...
I gotta go on the road. I'm a gypsy.
I literally picture it because I think we're just gonna have to do this song. This will be our next yeah. dynamic duel because this is my cousin's, you know,
spirit animal.
Not, a lot of people are like, spirit animals.
We're just kidding. It's not serious. We are very Christian. We love our Jesus Christ, Lord, our Savior.
Yes. No, but what I'm saying is, like, I love Selena and...
I love Stevie.
And she loves Stevie, so that's the way it is for us.
Yeah, we support each other in those...
Yeah, but I was gonna say, because it's like, all my life, like, for instance, my real father, I don't know who he is.
Ooh.
Remember, Mom? Stay tuned for that, with the rest of that story.
Yeah.
We're gonna go on our little...
I wish we could meet him, because...
You know, my mom said she was going to try her best to see.
He's still alive?
I don't know. He was a lot older than her. Oh. But my father was a musician. That's where I get my talents from.
Yeah, and then she just happened to get dropped into our musician family.
Yeah.
That's so crazy.
But it was, because that's what it was meant to be. Yeah. It was meant to be that.
Yeah. So it was like, Lord, it was like, this is who she needs to be with.
Exactly.
To nurture her already natural born.
Yep.
That's a trick.
Exactly. All right, hold on one second.
Okay.
Stays just like that. Guess what? What? I'm gonna pause this for a second.
Why? It's still going. There you go.
Oh, wait. Okay. Yeah, okay. Anyhow. But no, that's what I feel is like. So, right now, what we're gonna talk about is just. So, my cousin, I was like going on Facebook, as you all notice, those are people from Facebook. You know, our followers, it's just like, I've withdrawn myself from Facebook, and because I'm doing TikToks too.
Yeah.
But I thought that TikTok is more secluded.
Right.
So like more
private, almost.
Private. Kind of. Because when you do lives, they don't record and they upload to, you know, to be rewatched, to do a playbacks or anything like that. I love that about it.
Yeah.
Because a lot of people that are tied into my other half, ex other half, the family
are all on Facebook, huh?
And you know, I disconnected myself for them because Armando and I are no longer a relationship,
right?
Because I don't want them to see, you know, they don't need to see this. I mean, I'm sure they're gonna see it at some point, but I just really think that everything that happened was very unfair,
right?
We had had a discussion,
arrangement
in the beginning, that when we got into this relationship that was supposed to be different. And may I remind you, if you're watching, Armando, you said in a relationship different from all the rest. And I was like, cool, you know what? No judgment here about what my past was, his past was. I pretty much accepted him the way he was. I knew that he was very like upfront and true about what he had to say. There was no filters. That's what I loved about him. I admire very much of him being a strong individual.
Yeah.
Very smart.
Yeah.
I mean, I loved him, and I will say loved him, because I don't have that love anymore him, for the fact that he killed that.
I know.
Not only did he neglect this relationship, you know, he was amazing as a provider and a protector. But the only thing he didn't provide was that emotional part in
the intimacy.
The intimacy, the, you know,
affection
and the love to, you know, it was just, I just felt like it was just there.
Yeah. Ooh, and like a disconnection.
Huh? Yeah, and it was like 6 years.
That sucks.
6 years of that.
Yeah.
But I didn't go, I'm not the only one that went through that.
Right.
I mean, he's had other people in his life that went through that, but I'm not going to go into that part.
Right.
I'm just saying they experienced the same thing, but I'm pretty sure they had their flaws or whatever.
Everybody has flaws, yeah.
But I do know that I'm not a bad human being. I'm a good
person. I know.
And you know
me. You didn't deserve any of
the
this.
The person that I used to be, I would never have taken this.
I know.
Life. I would have left. Nor would I have never moved in with him.
I know.
But he was like, oh, you know.
Just trust me.
Trust me. Move in here. You're always here anyways. You can move here, and it's temporary until we build the business.
Yeah.
He offered me that business. I didn't ask him for the business. He offered it to me. He did give me my dream, you know, but the thing is,
he took it away now, so that doesn't count.
He says I could keep the business, but there's no money, there's no nothing.
I know.
And it's like, right now, he's not talking to me. He's very mad and angry because I decided to move on. He uses the COVID. You know, I know a lot of people are still dying out there and stuff, but I had COVID.
And he never got it. And still hasn't gotten it.
No.
And if he gets it, it ain't gonna be because of you.
He can't.
And there's nothing you can't control. I mean, you could try, obviously, you could take many, many precautions, but if you're gonna get it, you're gonna get it.
Yeah. I mean, so everybody out there, wear your face mask, wash your hands, sanitize, and be careful when you're out there in your surroundings and out in public or whatever. I mean,
but the sad part is you still have to work, you still have to live until you die.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And you can't constantly, I mean, work. I don't know. I guess because I always had anxiety, how you said you never really experienced that.
I know, I experienced that.
I've always had anxiety, and I had to learn how to, like, because that was, like, consuming my life, and I had to learn how to, like, realize, do I want to live in fear all the time where I can't even enjoy the life that I'm living?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And I had to let it go, you know?
That's true. And it's like, for me, it's just, I'm a person that has, I'm a busy body, I'm full
You're
of energy,
free.
And I'm a free person.
Carefree.
And I'm just out there doing what I need to do. Ever since I entered this relationship, it was always like, why are you doing that? You're wasting your time in doing that.
Yeah.
You need to concentrate
everything
more on
you
this.
Did. Yeah.
You need to do this. So it was always constant dictation. I don't think he realizes that.
Yeah,
maybe he does
it's
know.
Like his nature.
Yep, his nature. And it's the thing is that he didn't realize how that was affecting me horribly.
I know.
for being a person, even before COVID hit.
Oh, I remember. I know.
I mean, he never said, where are you going? You're not going
to
go.
But this girl has never been one to just be stuck in the house, because we would always go hiking or go have coffee or just walk around the freaking Dollar Tree. Obviously, we have that on video from last Halloween. That was good. But little by little, he was just not wanting her to do anything.
And it's not like he didn't directly tell me, but you could tell it was bothering me.
But it was causing like friction. Everything.
Yeah, it was, because then eventually he would get an opportunity or find an opportunity to tell me, you know, you've been going here, going there, and you need to, this was before COVID, you know, it's like,
yeah.
Never really controlled, never was like a jealous person that I know of him to be that. I mean, I could go do my gigs, and he never was constantly like, where are you at, what are you doing? One time he thought I was doing something because I did something out of
but you know what, it just hit me what it is? It just hit me. Because I'm a parent. You know when you're a parent, how it's annoying when the kids go in and out, and it's like, but you're not a child, though. Yeah. That's the difference of it. It's almost like he was almost not programmed, but like used to having the kids, having the, and being like kind
that's
of like
a load of shit, no.
No, I'm not making excuses for him. But I'm just saying, I could see how he would be like so stuck in that way of thinking that he's thinking of you like a child, and you're not a child.
Yeah, I know anything.
No matter how he tries to slice it.
Yeah.
You're still an adult. Slice it, yeah, you're still an adult, and you're responsible for yourself no matter what, you know?
Mm-hmm. And the thing is, it's just so sad because now it's like I was forced out of his house because he started to use the COVID. But he's just mad because I'm taking into controlling my own. I'm a grown ass woman,
right?
And I'm gonna go do this, and I'm gonna do that, and I have every right to go do that.
If you have a goal, or if you want for yourself, see, that's where relationships fail. I always feel like, because you have to have complete trust, but you have to trust each other enough to let the other person grow and do what they want to do without always... You shouldn't have to feel like you have to babysit somebody now.
No, and that's just the thing.
Because then you're miserable, whether it's the guy or the girl or whatever.
And check this out. Look, and I was home waiting for him to only not get a kiss when he come home.
I know.
This man works, 12, 13 hours. He drives I'm not going to explain what his job is, but, you know, he drives a truck and he's gone for hours.
Yeah.
Literally, he doesn't sleep in the bed with me. He has to go to work.
Yeah.
I like the setup. I like that, you know, that was great. I had my own time.
You had your own time and stuff.
But a lot of the times I didn't go anywhere and I stayed waiting for him.
I know.
Make him food or whatever. But to only just not have any conversation.
When he came, huh?
When he came. No kiss, hello. Literally, I could be in the back room. You think he comes looking for me? No. No talk, you know, I get it, you're tired. And,
right.
But you got to think about this. You're not talking or communicating with me at all any day.
Yeah, and you have to have some kind of communication.
Oh, but when he wanted time, attention, or whatever, then he
then
got
you better
it.
Get it. No.
But that's bad. No, but what I'm saying is that when he wanted to get physical, let's get physical.
I know.
Physical. It was just...
Then you drop everything, honey, and get to work.
You know, physical. And
I know.
And then he would like...
Then when you want to...
No, yeah, it's never really... Basically
mutual. Yeah.
And I would do things with him because I missed him and want to be with him. But then on another hand, I started noticing it was just, we do it. And then
go
through the motions. And then I'm just like, wow. Where's the kiss?
Connection. Where's the connection?
Me. Where's the connection? He used to kiss me. Whatever happened about both being happy when we were intimate.
Right. And let it be a mutual...
You know, but... It's like I was taking what I could get.
Right.
And that's... You shouldn't ever feel
like that. You should
like
never feel like that. I know.
I mean, he did tell me. He goes, look, I'm not perfect. Relationships aren't perfect. But I don't give a flying fuck.
That's not asking for too much. Just for somebody to say hi to you. And, hey, I'm home.
There would be times, though.
Maybe just give me 15 minutes, okay?
Mandy, there would be times that all I wanted was to tell him about my day.
Right, I know.
And he would act all irritated, but...
Like, get out of my face like you're a kid, huh?
Yeah, and and there's times he told me that I was, like, too much.
Yeah.
And I was like, wow, you know, and those are facts. Uh-huh. They're not lies.
I believe it, because I think you're just too much woman for that guy.
It's not just for him, not just him, but people. You know, just people that are not ready for someone like me that is so independent that is a person that
and
just...
And you're very high energy.
He always used to joke around, talk to me about, like, when I talk about, that was magical. Mm-hmm. That song is so magical. Uh-huh. That's not magical. We need to start talking about magical, you know. But you know what? And you know it's true.
Yeah.
Okay? And I, he would always, like, put those things down.
Everything.
Because I was like a Debbie Downer.
Negative.
I could never talk about...
Enjoy a moment.
I could never talk about a song, Mandy, and him not put it down, or that's a shitty singer, or I'm like, coming from a man that he loves music, he comes from a family of musicians, he just chose sports, but what I'm saying is that he would just like knock everything down that I would say.
Aww.
And you know that's true, you know? I could never say anything.
That sucks.
It would be turned into an argument.
Yeah.
You're always combative. You're always argumentative. I'm like, has it ever occurred to you?
That's like having just a negative. When you have a negative approach to anything, it's like a contaminator. It just contaminates everything.
I've told them, does it ever occur to you that you're the combative?
Yeah.
You're the argumentative person? Why is it always me?
If you start out, if you're saying something happy and he's saying something negative, what does that tell you? He's throwing the negativity in the whole inner of the end, making it negative.
I really gotta say that we've had some happy times, but majority of the time it was just always telling me what to do, what I was doing wrong, and what was I not doing right.
Yeah.
I could never, and
just because it's not what
I
he
I could never
thinks.
Outlive whatever I did wrong. He
right.
About it. I call him the grudge hoarder.
Oh my God.
He's
the grudge holder?
No, hoarder.
Oh.
He hoards.
The grudges. Oh my God.
He never lets them go. And to me.
So he like stalks, he like
He's a pack rat. We're so
with the grudges.
We're so because someone's sleeping for work. But basically, he's a grudge hoarder and he likes to pack it up like a pet.
He hoards the grudges.
Yeah. You know, a pack rat. Pack rats it. You know, it's not right.
Jeez.
He's 8 years older than me. And I love older men.
Yeah.
I figured, you know, he's great. I knew exactly that I loved him for the fact that he was...
older and settled and like...
Yeah, but to me, age is a number, but...
Then it just got... It turned out not good.
No, because it's just like, obviously I'm just too much of a light and...
In a dark place, honey.
Yeah.
He needed shades.
No, I don't know. He's just a person, an individual that needs something.
He wanted to stay in the dark.
If you want a woman that you knew exactly what I was when you met me.
Right.
And you tried to trim me and change me.
Right.
Even though you neglect, you say no, but you didn't like that it was too loud or too much. You always tried to trim everything about me. And when someone does that, at some point in time, I will give 100% of myself.
Yeah.
And I will look at, maybe he's right. Maybe I'm
this. Yeah,
you'll
examine it.
He was always telling me this and that.
And after a while, you're like, why?
Yeah.
Stupid, man.
I would really sit and think about this
shit. Yeah, like maybe I am wrong.
I would.
Poor baby, you were questioning yourself.
All the time.
And then you're like, what the hell is this?
But I know who I am.
I know.
I know
you're a grown
I'm
person.
About.
You're not a little kid.
I've been through some shit. Even down to cooking in the kitchen and stuff, he'll be like, here, do it this way. And I'm like,
you know how long I've been doing this?
I know how to do this shit.
Yeah.
Mandy, didn't I not work for freaking food and beverage for how many years?
I know, years.
I've worked in food and food catering, worked in big kitchens,
right.
And resorts. I've done it all. And every time I would try to share my expertise with him, he never wanted to hear me.
I know.
I didn't know shit. Well, he didn't say that, but just saying everything that's how he behaved with me is like, he never wanted to hear me out.
Right.
You know, a couple of times he would, you know, try to yell at me in front of people, and then I finally said, no, that's inappropriate for you to be doing, which shocked me because I didn't think he would ever do that.
Yeah.
He said it a few times in front of his kids. But
oh
see,
my God.
His family knows how he is.
Yeah, they already know.
Without a doubt, he is a good guy to a certain point.
You just became incompatible.
Yeah, and that's just the way it is. And
but then he's not that's being nice because that's making it where it's both of you are just not compatible, but truly he's being negative too. Mm-hmm. He's been being more negative.
Yeah, and he was. And he you was know very you negative. Were. And yeah. You know you were.
Yeah.
And it's sad that I have to sit here and talk.
Yeah.
On a video, because I know you're watching.
Right.
And I'm not doing this to be a jerk or say that you're a horrible human being. It's just
right, because we're not even calling you out. We could be calling, saying the name and
yeah, but
and
the
we
thing
don't
want
to do that. We're not trying to do that.
What I'm trying to say is you never gave me the chance to really tell you how I felt because you controlled it too much. You controlled how I talked, what I said, and how I needed to say it. And just say okay. I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen. I hate that word. I've never in my life said that I hated anything. But when I hear people, okay, oh, lights a fire under my ass.
Because he would try to force you to say
that.
He
has his kids trained that, and his exes to this day will say okay when he's talked to
like, okay,
but I'm not going to get into that part of that's none of my business. Like, you tell me, you know nothing about that. Oh, I do, because your family has talked to me plenty about that.
Yeah.
But let's leave that there. All I'm saying is, this is about me now. This is why I left this relationship. It was toxic. It was unhealthy. It was not at all what we talked about we wanted to do with it. Because it's two people in a relationship.
Right.
Okay? Not one.
Right. Exactly.
He's the one that made decisions. I could never make that house that I lived in for 6 years with him my own.
I know. Or even just a part of it, you know.
And when the things that I did do, I heard an earful of it for doing it.
Yeah.
Next time you need to ask me, talk to me first about what you're going to do. Like, you've been hanging stupid ass shit on the walls. But that's something that he's always been that way, because the girls told me.
Yeah.
Every one of your kids have told me that. I ain't lying. Once you ask them, they'll tell you.
Yeah.
Well, you know, so they will tell you.
Yeah.
And it's sad because I was the woman of the house that was... What, I need to be at home?
Yeah.
If I'm not doing whatever.
If you're going to be stuck at home, you want it to be your home, at least, and have things you like
it
to look at.
It was never my home.
Right.
It was never anything. Anything that was given to it, it was never mine. Because you know what he's doing right now? He's even holding my things.
I know, hostage.
He's mad because I made a choice and I'm moving forward and I'm not letting him, control me.
Yeah.
You know, I'm an adult and I can make a choice. Sorry. He said you can stay here as long as whatever until you need to. And then that changed because he got mad because I started going to work.
Right.
And he was telling me, you don't care about me. You don't care that you're going to get me sick. And I'm like, I do care about you. That's why I'm being careful. And now this is why I'm sleeping in my own room. Because they're for already weeks, almost a month or two or more. I can't even remember to tell the truth. Mandy, no intimacy, and we've been fighting, and that's sad. I feel like I Love Lucy, where freaking Lucille Ball and Desi Arnaz are sleeping in two separate beds in the same room.
Right.
I never would want to do that, but I was doing it. I was sleeping in my own room because of that.
Separate rooms.
You know how sad it is? Like, you want their love and their attention, and they freaking...
There's nothing they could do about it.
They don't want to give you that?
Yeah.
You know how fucked up that is? Pretty sad.
That is.
It's pretty sad because I was alone in a house, you know, and he was there, but I was alone.
But you're still feeling alone.
And even then, like, even when I tried to talk to him about my feelings, he told me that I could talk to him, but as soon as I would say stuff, that I would be silly.
Yeah.
And no, he didn't want to hear the truth.
Right.
And I did get, the times that I got mad at him, I did tell him, I said, you know what? It's like, you neglected this relationship. And this is why I made the choice that I did.
Mm-hmm.
But he tries to blame me for everything.
Mm-hmm.
But I try to tell him, I said, you neglected this relationship. You didn't give me love, affection, attention. I was crying, Mandy, telling him this.
I know. I remember you telling me.
And it seemed like
the last, like, 3 years, that's all you've been trying to... So, like, the last 3 years are just basically, like, was disintegrating, huh?
Yeah.
Little by little.
And it's just like anywhere down to even when we go on vacations.
Mm-hmm.
One time, I mean, he did take me for my birthday. I think it was 2 years ago, right? To Universal's.
Mm-hmm.
He surprised me. He knows me very well.
Yeah.
He knows the foods I like. He could literally order for me and get it right.
Aww.
I mean, it was amazing. He listened.
Yeah.
That's what's so heartbreaking.
That's what hurts you, I know.
Because, and then he turns
around.
It's
like so close, but yet so far.
He knew everything, but then he didn't know how to give me the love that I wanted and that I deserved.
Yeah.
No affection. Right. In the beginning, we were like laughing. We would joke around and wrestle and all kinds of stuff. But then everything just started to deflate. It started to just like, I don't know why. Because he would get mad at me because I finally started speaking up.
Yeah.
I started fighting back and telling him what I thought about things. Yeah. I didn't like what he was saying. And no, I'm not going to just say okay.
Yeah.
Because I go, you know why? I'm not going to say okay. You remember that I told you that. I'm not going to say okay because has it ever occurred to you that sometimes it isn't okay?
Right, with
and
you.
I'm not just going to say okay. And no one should be forced to say okay.
When it's not.
There'd be a lot of times. And either things would happen in the house, he would blame me and said, you did this and that. Like, he lost like 2 tarps, you know, the things that cover the cooler, because there's a swamp cooler and a regular cooler.
Right.
He says that I lost them both.
And just how would you lose it?
I don't know. Like, he says, like,
how do you lose a tarp?
No, but listen, I don't know what happened with the stuff. Have you forgotten that there's people that where there's like homeless people?
Yeah, they probably came over and got it.
I don't know. But all I know is that he blames me for things that I did.
Yeah.
I don't even remember doing or I didn't do.
You know you didn't.
And he still says,
to this day.
Remember, there's only 2 of us in this house. Hasn't it occurred to you that you probably misplaced
it? Yeah, or maybe you didn't forget.
Gloria. No, Gloria. It's like I had to sit there. Oh, I'm sorry.
And say okay and all that, huh?
And go with the blame.
Yeah, or else he would be mad, huh?
Yeah, he'd get mad and talk shit to me. We get into an argument because we might know, but I didn't do it. And then I'm down like this. And you remember that I said it to you like this. But I didn't do it. You know what you said to me and how you said it. And it's sad. It's fucked up. If I didn't love him and didn't care about him and really try to work it, why would I stay there 6 years? You knowing how I do things.
I know. And honestly, you gave it so many tries because you were really done with it. And you just kept trying and trying and trying to where the point where there was nothing left to fight for.
He was great with everything else, but he just like... And you know the thing that really...
Hey, man, having an emotional connection with in your relationship is like has to be one of the most important things. You know?
It wasn't. It's like...
Because otherwise, what do you have then? If you don't have that, you don't have nothing.
There isn't a thing. This is why I made the choice that I did. And just... I cried a lot.
I know.
That even now that separating myself from him and leaving him...
Right.
I don't even care if someone came... right now and be with them. Yeah. I don't care if they slept with them. You know why? Because I don't have that feeling anymore.
It's killed.
A lot of people, how can you lose that right away? You just broke up with them. No.
But you guys were...
No. My heart has been dying slowly, bit by bit.
That's what I mean for like the last 3 years.
And so this is why I gave it all she's got, Scotty.
Right.
Star Trek ship.
Yep.
You know?
Abort like, mission.
You know? But I've given it all I could. And why get mad at me now? Because I wanted to march forward and continue doing what I needed to do. He's taking it like he says it's COVID, but no, he's mad at me because I stand up for myself. I stood up for myself, and I started telling him no. I'm sorry, but I have to do what I need to do to make my money. You already pay all the bills.
Yeah.
You pay everything. Well, I still need to make my money. If I want to buy me something online, or if I want to do things, or who knows, you ripping the carpet from underneath me and leaving me pretty much homeless because you want me out of the fucking house because you can't have
homeless, carless, everything.
Yeah. And this is the sad thing is that I am the primary in the car, and him yelling at me, it's not your car, it's the bank's car. Well, I texted this and I said, well, since you're paying for the house, it is not your house until you pay it off, then it becomes your house.
Yeah.
Your fucking house that you kicked me out of.
The bank's house.
Which I know I have every right. I've been living there 6 years.
Right.
6 years. I have every right to go and get my things without you dictating when and how I can do it.
Right.
You have no right telling me that. No right.
Mm-hmm.
And so, but what did I do? Even though I knew the law and I know what I can do.
Your rights.
I left. And right. I listened. I gave you the keys to the house like you asked me. You took my paperwork to my car. You know, it's like, and then you know what, Mandy? When I went over there the day that I asked him Wednesday, this past Wednesday, if I could go when we're talking, mm-hmm. we're still talking. If I could get a couple of things, which I got my TV, mm-hmm. Suitcase of clothes, but all my shit is in there. Because he said, leave it all here. You don't have to pay for a storage. You don't have to do anything. You know, he claims that I wasn't trying to do anything the last day that he kicked me out of the house, which was Saturday. Like, I had to up and go. But no car, no nothing, but he wanted me out. I don't know who's pressuring him.
Yeah, who the hell, he thought you were going to do all that.
You know, after what the arrangements we had, he says it's because of COVID, that he's scared of COVID and that I'm going to infect them. Get out of here with that.
That's bull crap. Because he's still going to go to the store. He's still going to go to work. He's still going to be around other people.
And he's probably still going to be with that flufla.
Yeah.
You know? I don't care, though.
I know.
You can have him. If you're watching this video, whoever you are, have him. And I hope you pay attention to this video, because what you're getting, honey,
is not what you think.
I don't know if he is or isn't, but I do know something that has been going on with him. I already talked to him about it. But what I don't care, though, if there is another. I even told him, I don't care. Mm-hmm. All I want is my car. Give me my fucking car, because it's my car. It is my car. As long as I don't fall behind payments and continue making the payments, it's my car, not yours. Right. You have no rights. You're breaking the law, mister. Right. Not only that, you opened my mail. He opened my mail and read me that letter. He thought that I wasn't going to get the car. Every single day.